But now we're down to the big boys on the big stages. We're at Elland Road tonight.
Mr. Elland Road, for the first time as a Blackburn player, over 2 years after his transfer across the Pennines. And on the day that he and Graham Lasseau were banned for 2 matches by UEFA for their infamous dust-up in Moscow last week. The only change made by Howard Wilkinson from the team beaten at Newcastle sees Brolin's debut with Richard Jobson cup-tied. Carlton Palmer reverts to a centre-back role. Blackburn boss Ray Harford solves a similar riddle with a straight swap. Lars Bohinen, in brilliant form since his move from Nottingham Forest, is ineligible, so Scottish international Billy McKinley steps up. One of the Premier League's top officials, Keith Cooper, has made the journey from South Wales to take charge. There's over £40 million worth of talent on view at Elland Road this evening. Over £24 million of that possessed by Blackburn Rovers, playing in a change strip tonight of red and black. The strip that's not been too fortunate for them in European competition. And now Batty. Very much a Leeds boy, David Batty. And I think the fans here are appreciating that. They'd like to see him back here one day, I think. Here goes Dorigo down the left. But a little back heel made a present of the ball. Now Brolin with his first touch of the ball. Ford finding Gary Kelly, continuing a remarkable run of consecutive appearances, Gary Kelly for Leeds. Tonight his 117th match in a row since making his full debut. Brolin. I'm not sure what McAllister was intending there, but he's played the ball straight downfield for Tim Flowers, the lead skipper. Ray Harford in the centre of the picture, Derek Fazakerley on his left, chief coach. What a season he's had, Ray Harford. He said before the game, it's just from bad to worse with so much media attention. That's been the problem. He also reckons the fact that Blackburn have had so many matches has really hampered them. 23 games played. Now Newell. Wide is Ripley. Ripley versus Dorigo here, and Ripley will get a cross in, and it comes, and it's going to be just toe poked wide in the end. Shearer and Newell between them unable to take the chance that occurred. There's a strange sort of opening with nobody able to get a conclusive touch here. Ripley did well to get around Dorigo. Palmer was at full stretch, and then it just came off Newell, really. For Brolin. As expected, Brolin is playing in what they call a hole in footballing terms, just behind Tony Yeboah, with Brian Deane on a white ride berth tonight. Sometimes plays wide down the left, tonight he's down the right. And here is Brolin. Ford. That's the first moment to thrill the crowd. He was a long, long way out there, Yeboah, over 30 yards. He really had to tussle to win the ball from Hendry. Then he skipped around Lasseau, and the only thing on his mind from that moment was to try and hit the target. That he did, but Flowers was there. Tony Yeboah and Alan Shearer at the other end, who have both got terrific goal-scoring records, of course, are two of the only 5 English-based players nominated for European Footballer of the Year. And Shearer's got a wonderful goal-scoring record against Leeds United. 8 goals in the last 3 seasons against them, including a hat-trick here 2 years ago. Nice to see the wheelchair spectators here, given a vantage point for viewing. And it's Leeds on the attack. But Hendry's boot nips that one in the bud. Dylan McKinley, the most recent signing at £1.75 million from Dundee United. Ford was in quickly there, that's his game, and he does it well. Mark Ford, who's fought his way into this Elland Road starting lineup. Oh, a lovely dummy by Brolin. And now Brolin with a shot! Good try! How he loved that that one have gone in. A moment to excite the Elland Road fans with their first glimpse of Tomas Brolin. First of all, he dummied over the ball, then McAllister, then Deane, and the swinging shots were just wide. That will have encouraged him. He scored four goals in the last two World Cup finals for Sweden, so he knows the way to the net. Newell up against Wetherill, who wins. And then it's Sherwood. Here's Lasso. Newell's taken up an intelligent position there, but harassed by Kelly. He has to play the ball back for McKinley. And Leeds have everybody behind the ball, though Shearer still manages to find a shot. And even though it's a long way high, and wide, Shearer won't care about that. Did well to get a shot in of any kind. Chesting it down so well. Not finishing quite as adroitly. Two lovely touches there from Dorigo. He just got a knock on his ankle at the weekend, but now he's conceded possession to Batty. Blackburn with three in the middle. If they can get a decent ball up through here, it's Ripley. Can't get past Palmer though. So neither can speed deliver a clearance. So Ripley has another tilt at Dorigo. Oh, and Palmer sliced it. And the header from McKinley was screwed a long way wide. Ripley with the ball across here, and Carlton Palmer just lunged at it and got it wrong. So did McKinley. Now Brolin with a bit of space. Dean on his outside, only McAllister up the middle at the moment. So Brolin now tries to thread it in. And he does that well. And a corner won by McAllister for Leeds. For which Wetherill will go up. Palmer stays back this time. It's in from McAllister. There's a bit of pushing and shoving went on there. It's all to the satisfaction of the referee, however. And now Wetherill still up. In comes Dean. By that scything shot from Dino. Kelly was the one who picked it back up again, and when it was knocked out, Hendry dwelled a little and Dean punished him. Kelly's cross, Wetherill who won it there well, but Hendry, I'm sure, was unaware that Dean was lurking with menace. 1-0 Leeds United, Deans at third of the season, and they've come against Middlesbrough, Newcastle and now Blackburn. So it's a good spell for Brian Deane. Sherwood. Shearer. Little nudge onto Newell. He'll keep it in. And then Ripley gets a corner. Blackburn have beaten Swindon and Watford to reach this stage. Leeds having overcome Notts County and Derby. And Blackburn have scored a few goals in the competition as well, but that's Brolin with a header away. Ripley again, hits it in low. Batty, roundly booed now, and here's a free shot. And here's another one coming in from Hendry. Shearer had the first stab at it, Hendry the second, and there was plenty of venom in that effort. Colin Hendry, just like Deane, was a scorer here only a few months ago. Shearer's first effort came back to him, and he didn't hang around either. Just one goal this season. That was in a 5-1 victory against Coventry, but he did score here in April. Paul Hart and Peter Gumby among the Leeds think tank tonight down there. Seven of them in the dugout on the touchline in all. The manager's hiding for the moment. He's no need to do. His team are in front. There's a useful flick if it releases Ripley. Excellent covering again by Palmer, who runs away from Ripley with those great long legs of his. Speed now into McAllister, and Leeds have options here. Come back for Dorigo, and the high ball in is towards Deane. Oh, Blackburn sloppily give the ball back to Yeboah. He might try one of his specials! Special it was! He's back on some. That's what he's been wanting for so long. He doesn't bother with tap-ins. And when Blackburn gave the ball to Tony Yeboah, they committed suicide. Mike Newell to the Yeboah. One touch, two touches, three touches, four. Thank you very much. Nothing Flowers could do about this. And the Ghanaian has his 13th goal of the season, but only his second in 11 games. No wonder his eyes lit up. Wham. Now then, Shearer versus Palmer. All England colleagues. And a foul by Shearer, according to the linesman. It's going to be a tough challenge tonight between these two. There was a little push there from Shearer, without question. 18 goals, though, this season, including a couple of hat-tricks. So a man leads fear, without doubt, Alan Shearer. Speed gets up superbly. Now Yeboah, lovely back heel, speed again, and right across goal. Plenty of resolve and plenty of fluency about Leeds' game tonight. And here, speed got up, Yeboah dragged it back, then the back heel. Picture book stuff until the finish. Ray Harford must be very concerned about the goals that his side has conceded away from home in particular. That's 23 now, and they've scored only 9. Sherwood. McKinley missed it. It enabled Brolin to set speed on his way. And off he goes, knowing Yeboah's on his left. Speed, Yeboah, and he'll go into that area. And he's still here, Yeboah. Just to hold things up now. Does get the ball across in the end, and it'll come to Deane, who fires it in. And it was pinging around all over the place there, without anybody in a white shirt getting a crucial touch. And Shearer is offside. Well, Yeboah here, he slices this. You never know what's on in his mind, whether he was actually going for goal or not there. Anyway, it stayed in play, long enough for Deane to hammer it back across goal. And he's causing panic at the moment in those Blackburn ranks. Brolin, and then from Yeboah. Well, Ford's going to try his luck now. A scrambling stop. Ford obviously not yet scored a first-team goal for Leeds. And he made life difficult for Tim Flowers here. Obviously there's a shoot on sight policy from Leeds tonight. It's been an excellent half for Leeds. After a diffident sort of opening, Brian Green smashed them ahead after catching the centre-back Hendry asleep, and then Tony Yeboah with a special extended that Leeds advantage. So at half-time at Elland Road, it's Leeds United 2, Blackburn Rovers 0.